just to give you an example, I am taking the value of q as greater than 7. Let us say I am assuming the value as 8. Also p also I have assumed greater than 7. Let me take this also as 8, just for an example point of view. Now, going as per our regular procedure, we find row minimum. So in first row, the minimum is 2. In second row, now minimum is 7. Okay. And third row, minimum is 4. Then what we see, what is the maximum of all these three? So maximum is 7. Hence, maximin, I got 7. And this criteria is satisfied. So I put a right here. Now let us go column wise. Column, what we check, what are the maximum values in the column? So maximum value in this column is 10. Maximum value in this column now becomes 8. And maximum value in this column also becomes 8. Now what happens? In this, we select the minimum one. So minimum comes out to be 8. That means this condition is not satisfied. We need the answer there as 7. I can't assume this condition that q is greater than 7 and p is greater than 7. So this condition is not favorable condition. Now let us assume another condition.
Sir, will you please explain the last problem once again?
Find range of values p and q which will render the entry 2,2 as saddle point for the game. And question was given like this. So as per our regular procedure, what we do, we make two more columns and two more rows in the question given. So I have made that also. Then in this question, we are already given the answer, or we are required to find out what are the values in the matrix, which is P and Q. So now we will go backward. Backward means I have the answer as value of the game as 7. Why 7? Because in the question it is given 2,2 as saddle point. So saddle point answer, we take it as value of game. And 2,2, the value is 7. So I wrote answer as value of the game equal to 7. So as value of the game is 7, I have now maximin and minimax also equal to 7. Because this answer we only take as the value of the game. So I am now proceeding backwards. Now I want to find out range of values. So let me first assume that, let us say q is less than 7 and p is also less than 7. Okay. My assumption is q is less than 7 and p is less than 7. Just to make you understand, let me start with the values so that it is easy for understanding. So numerical value, let us say I am taking less than 7 as 6, and here also I am taking 6 because it is less than 7, just for assumption now. Now in first row, the minimum is 2. In second row, now the minimum is 6. Third row, minimum is 4. And then what we do, we find out maximum of this all three entries.
4.
So maximum of all these three entries is 6 now. Okay, so as maximum is 6, this violates our condition of 7. Okay, now let us go to the column side. Let us see whether this works in column or no. So in column, what we do, we find out the maximum one. So maximum from this is 10. Maximum from this is 7. So I will write 7. And maximum from this is 6. And then what we do, we find out minimum of this. Then again, it comes out to be 6. So again, this is also violating the condition that value of the game is not coming out to be 7. So this condition will also not work. So in first stage, we have seen both of them greater than 7. That was also not working. In this case, I saw both less than 7. This case was also not working. Let me try. So let us go to the next assumption. Next assumption is again same, but assumption now I will make is, let us say q is greater than or equal to 7 and p is less than or equal to 7. So again, I will take one numerical example. Q is greater than 7. So let us say I am taking 8, and p less than or equal to 7. So let us say I am taking it as 6. Again, we will follow the procedure. 2, 4, 5, minimum is 2. 10, 7 and 8, minimum is 7. And 4, 6 and 6, minimum is 4. Now from this, we take the maximum. So maximum is 7. And here also we are getting 7. That means this condition is satisfied. Now let us say whether it is satisfied in column also or not. column we take the maximum. So maximum from this is 10. Maximum from this column is 7. And maximum from this column will be 8. Okay, now we take the minimum of this. So minimum of this is 7. Hence, here also the condition has been satisfied. Hence, I will tell that as both the condition are satisfied, my range of values for P and Q will be greater than or equal to 7, and P should be always less than or equal to 7. This completes the solution. Now, any doubts? Yes. So this was the question. I again form the matrix. In a game of matching coins, player A wins rupees 2 if there are 2 heads, wins nothing if there are 2 tails, and loses rupee 1 when there is 1 head and 1 tail. Determine the payoff matrix, best strategy for each player, and the value of the game. Now here the matrix is not given to you. The payoff matrix you have to make by reading the statements. So I will make first the table. Player A, he can show head or tails. Player B also can show head or tails. Now as per the statements, player A wins rupees 2 if there are 2 heads. So if player A and player B both show heads, then player A will win rupees 2. So this 2 will come in this intersection. Then wins nothing if 2 tails and loses rupees 1. It loses rupees 1. So I will write minus 1 in place of tail head and head tail. And wins nothing if there are 2 tails. So I will write here 0. Now this becomes my question for further solution. So I have given you time also to solve this question. So if someone have solved, please explain.
Sir, row minimum will be minus 1.
Okay, very good. Okay, bad.
And second row minimum will be minus 1. Now the max column maximum will be 2. First column maximum will be 2. And second column maximum will be 0. Now the minimax value will be 0. As the maximum value is not equal to minimax value, therefore there is no saddle point. Then we have to find the probability of player A showing head and probability of player A showing tail, that is P1 and P2. The formula of P1 is A22 minus A21 divided by A11 plus A22 minus A12 plus A21. So P1 will be 1 by 4.
Okay, P1 1 by 4. So I will calculate P2.
1 minus P1.
Okay, very good. Then similarly, we will go for
1 and Q2.
Yes. So what answer you get? Q1 and Q2.
Also coming out to be 1 by 4 and Q2 will be 3 by 4.
Okay, very good. So
value of the game is coming out to be 1 by 4.
Minus 1 by 4. Okay, good. Your answers are correct. How you will write final answer? Strategy for A.
1 by 4, comma 1 by 4, 3 by 4, sorry.
Yes, 1 by 4, comma 3 by 4. And for B?
1 by 4, comma 3 by 4.
Yes, both answers are coming same. So, any doubt to anyone in this question? It's just an application of formula and substituting the values. Only the last part is to write the answer in proper form. So, strategy for A, we have P1 and P2. So, first value will always appear as P1. So it is 1 by 4 which we have already calculated, and P2 we got out as 3 by 4. Similarly for B, first answer will be Q1, second answer will be Q2. So answer we got as 1 by 4 and 3 by 4 respectively. This completes the solution. Now let us go to the next problem. Okay, next method is the oddment method. I have taken the same example, the first example which we have taken in the arithmetical method, so that you can compare the difference of the method, but your answer will get same. So oddment method again. First step is to find out what is the, is there any saddle point exist? This is the first step in any problem of game theory. But as we have already seen in previous example, that saddle point does not exist. Hence, I am proceeding forward oddment method. Now, in oddment method, what you have to do, you have to make one column and one row as oddments. Now, oddment answer, how you have to calculate? You have two values in first row, 9 and 7. You have to take the difference of the two values. Listen to me carefully. It's difference of two values. So, it will be 9 minus 7. and it will be always bigger number minus smaller number. Please note this point. You have to always do the bigger number minus smaller number. So 9 minus 7 we are getting as 2. So 2, this 2 is the answer for first row, but its answer now will be written in the second row. 9 minus 7, 2, the answer will be written in second row. Now, second row, 5 and 11, I told that it is always bigger number minus smaller number. So it is 11 minus 5. 11 minus 5 will give you 6. This 6 will come at the first row. It's just an interchange of rows. You have to just take the difference and put it on the another row. Similar procedure we have to follow for column. Now, for first column, we have values 9 and 5. So 9 minus 5, answer is 4. This 4 will come in B2 column. So I will write it in the B2 column. And similarly, 11 minus 7, answer again comes 4, which will be written in the first column. Again, I repeat, you have to take the difference of bigger number and smaller number and place that value in another row. Agar first row ka kar rahe ho, to second row mein answer likho. Second row ka kar rahe ho, to first row mein likho. Similar procedure will be followed in the column part. Then next, directly I can write answer as P1 is equal to 6 divided by 6 plus 2. So P1 oddment was 6. So I will write 6 divided by the total of oddments. So it is 6 divided by 8, answer I will get 3 by 4. Now you can easily tell any of the answer. What you have to do, you have to just write the oddment divided by total number of oddments. This is a generalized formula. Oddment for that row divided by total oddments. Now, let us say I want to find out P2. So one of the thing is I can directly write 1 minus P1. That is okay, because we have the assumption that total probability is always be equal to 1. So this can also be done. I can write P2 is equal to 1 minus P1. I will get answer 1 by 4. But if I want to go about oddment method, what I will do? The oddment here is 2. For P2, the oddment comes out to be 2. So I will write 2 divided by total oddments is 6 plus 2, that is 8. So 2 divided by 8, again I will get the same answer, that is 1 by 4. Now let us start with Q1 and Q2. Then I will display the answers. First, let me explain. Let us say I am finding out Q1 for B1 and Q2 for B2. Ab kya hoga? Q1 ka answer chahiye mujhe. So what will be Q1? It is the oddment for that row, that will be 4 divided by total oddments. So it will be 4 divided by 8. So answer I will get as 1 by 2. Similarly for Q2, oddment is 4. So it will be 4 divided by total oddment is 8. So totally it will be 4 divided by 8. Answer will be 1 by 2. So let us see the answers now. Okay, P2 is 1 minus P1, Q1 and Q2. So here I have used P2 is equal to 1 minus P1 because I know the concept that total probability will always be equal to 1. So this procedure or this formula will also work, or you can also simply write oddment divided by total number of oddments. So after finding out P1, P2, Q1 and Q2, next step is to find out value of the game. Again, let me explain. There are 4 different formulas or 4 different ways where we can find out value of the game. Let us start one by one. First step, you can choose any of the row or any of the column. Okay, I will clear this. Okay, choose any one of the row or any one of the column. Let us say I am choosing this column. So my answer will be value of the game. I am talking about value of the game. Value of the game will be 9 multiplied by 6. I have to just multiply it oddments. 9 multiplied by 6 plus it will be 5 multiplied by 2. So 9, 6 is 54 I will get, and 5 into 2 I will get 10. And on adding, I will get 64. So just I am telling 9 multiplied by 6 plus 5 into 2. This answer should be divided by total number of oddments, which is 8. So I will get answer 64 divided by 8, answer as 8. So this is one of the formula. What can be other formula? Next formula will, so it will be 7 multiplied by 6. 7 into 6 will come as 42. And 11 multiplied by 2, I will get 22. So again, you will see that addition is 64. And this 64 should be divided by total number of oddments, that is 8. Again, I will get answer as 8. So again, you are getting the same answer. Now, what will be the third step or third case? Third case, now I have gone column wise.
4 plus 7.
Now I will go row wise. So my first row is 9 and 4. So it will be 9 into 4, that is 36. 9 4 are 36. And 7 multiplied by 4. So it will be 28. Again, you will see the total comes out to be 64. And if I divide it by 8, I will get answer again as 8. So this is the third case. And fourth case will be simple. 5 into 4, 20. 11 into 4, 44. So 44 plus 20 will comes out to be 64. 64 divided by 8 comes out to be 8. So any one of the formula you can use as per your wish, you will get the same answer of value of the game. So this I have already explained to you. There are four different ways in which we can calculate the value of the game. Now it is as per your wish, which formula or which thing you want to consider. Any doubts in this?
Sir, if player A or B mein do se zyada strategy hai, jaise ki A3 bhi agar aa gayi.
Yes.
तो ये वाला मेथड यूज कर सकते हैं.
वेरी गुड. दिस ऑडमेंट फार्मूला वर्क्स ओनली फॉर 2 बाय 2 मैट्रिक्स. द थिंग व्हिच आई हैव शोन इज जस्ट फॉर 2 बाय 2 मैट्रिक्स. एनी अदर डाउट्स?
नो सर.